Okay, so Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all of you. We should have, according to my list, kita ada 49 students registered for this class. Tapi maybe ada pertambahan, I'm not sure, so I will have to check lah. So yang saya check latest, I think a few days ago, we have 49 students lah registered in DMM 2523 Dynamics. Okay. So before we start, I would like to introduce myself. Maybe most of you belum pernah belajar dengan saya. My name is Muhammad Hasnun Arif bin Hassan. So people call me Hasnun, right? This is my contact number lah. So that's my office number, my phone number, email address and also WhatsApp. So if you have any problem, you can contact me through WhatsApp. But please bear in mind, only contact me during office hour lah. So I hope we can respect each other's privacy. Okay. Okay. A little bit about my academic background. I did my undergraduate study in Germany, and then I came back to do my master in University Malaya 2012, and then I did my PhD in UMP, graduated in 2016. Since 2016, I have been teaching in UMP lah. Okay, so I've been in UMP for 5 years now. Okay, let's go to the course synopsis of Dynamics, what you are going to learn. So basically, all of you have already passed statics lah, okay? Because statics is the prerequisite for dynamics, so all of you have already taken statics. So the different, basically, static and dynamic is under the same branch of study lah, which I will show you later. It is called engineering mechanics. So in statics, you learn about object that is not moving, but in dynamics we are going to solve or calculate problems related to moving objects. Okay, so this course introduces fundamental elements in the discipline of dynamics with the emphasis of motion of particles. Okay, dalam engineering mechanics there are two types of object that we consider. One is called particle, the other one is rigid body. So for diploma level dynamics, we are going to learn about motion of particles. When you go into degree level, you will learn about motion of rigid body. So rigid body will not be covered in dynamics for diploma. Okay, and then we will discuss a lot about kinematics and kinetics. Okay, kinematics ni maksud dia the characteristic of motion. Any object in motion, dia akan ada position, position tu location lah, current location of the object with respect to what we call the origin ataupun the coordinate system. So kita akan define a coordinate system, so the object, the position, kedudukan objek tu will be based on the coordinate system, the origin, and also the object will have velocity. Okay, so velocity ni semua tahulah, speed, measured in meter per second. So this is one of the characteristic of motion, and also we have acceleration ataupun dalam bahasa Melayu dipanggil pecutan. So acceleration ni how fast the velocity of an object is changing over time. So this is the acceleration. So all these three characteristics, which is position, velocity and acceleration, is known as kinematics. So kinematics ni ialah kita akan berbincang ataupun kita akan melihat or look into the characteristic of the motion. And also the second part ataupun bahagian yang kita akan belajar dalam dynamics is kinetics. Okay, kinetics means the force. Everything in motion, there must be a force yang applied to it. So because of the force, the object will move. Okay, tak ada objek yang akan bergerak dengan sendiri. Mesti ada certain force yang menyebabkan dia bergerak. If you place an object on, for example, on a inclined surface like this, if you have a surface like this, you place an object on the surface and the object move down, you will think that there is no force acting on the object, but that is not true. The force that is acting on object is the weight of the object. So because of the gravity, the weight is pointing down, so it will start moving downwards. So basically, memang akan ada force acting on the object which will cause the object to move. So any motion of the object is caused by external force acting on the object. So ini yang kita akan bincang dalam kinetics. So kalau tadi kinematics, we talk about position, velocity, acceleration. Dalam chapter yang melibatkan kinetics, we will talk about force yang mengakibatkan the forces that causing the motion of the object. Okay, and dekat sini if you see the classification of motion in rectilinear and curvilinear trajectory. So apa maksud dia? Rectilinear is the motion of the object in straight line. That is what we call rectilinear. And curvilinear is the motion of the object is in a circular path lah, ataupun is not a straight line. Okay, dia ada curve dan sebagainya. So that is called curvilinear motion. So basically kita akan belajar dua jenis motion lah. One is rectilinear, straight line. The second one is curvilinear motion. Okay, and the kinetics chapter. Okay, tadi kita dah bagi tahu kinematics involve position, velocity and acceleration. Kinetics is discussing the force acting on the object. Okay, so in kinetics dia akan dipecahkan kepada tiga bahagian. Okay, there is force and acceleration, there is work and energy, and finally there is impulse and momentum. So ada tiga subtopik yang kita akan bincangkan dalam kinetics. Okay, so ini ialah the synopsis of the course lah, the dynamics course that we are going to discuss throughout the semester. 14 minggu kita akan bincangkan all these topics. Okay, then we go to the course outcomes. So basically after completing dynamics course, you should understand all these four chapters lah. Course outcome ni kita boleh juga kita panggil sebagai chapters. So course outcome yang pertama ialah kinematics of particle. Tadi saya dah mention tentang kinematics involve position, velocity and acceleration. So this in the first chapter, we will discuss only kinematics of particles. Kita tak bincang tentang the force causing the motion. Only the kinematics, only the characteristic of the motion. Okay, the second chapter or the second course outcome will be on kinetics of particle using force acceleration concept. Okay, nanti kita akan tengok apa force acceleration concept ni. It's basically the Newton second law of motion. Kalau you ingat masa belajar dalam fizik, Newton ada introduce beberapa law of motion. Newton second law of motion ialah F equals to MA. Saya rasa semua pernah dengar F sama dengan M, the mass of the object multiply with the acceleration, M kali A. That will be the second course outcome, second chapter of this dynamics course lah. Okay, the third chapter Is still in kinetics, masih lagi berbincang tentang force causing the motion, tapi kali ini kita akan guna slightly different different concept, which is work and energy. Okay, kita akan bincang tentang kinetic energy. Okay, every object in motion, it will have kinetic energy, and then kita akan bincang juga tentang work done. Work done ni, maybe you have already heard about work done in physics. Okay, maybe you have already heard about work done in physics. So this is another topic that we will discuss in the third chapter of dynamics. Chapter yang terakhir, okay, dynamics kita ada 4 chapter sahaja. Chapter yang terakhir kita akan bincang tentang kinetics lagi. And in the last chapter, the concept will be using impulse and momentum. Okay, so kita basically dalam chapter kinetics ni ada 3 bahagian lah, ada 3 subtopik. Force acceleration, work energy, and the last one is impulse and momentum. Okay. Ada apa-apa soalan tak? Jelas tak? Saya punya suara clear tak? Boleh, semua boleh dengar?
Clear, sir.
Clear, sir.
Any of you in here has internet problem ke? You cannot hear my voice clearly ke? Semua okay ke?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, alright. So kalau tak okay, boleh boleh apa ni, you can stop me and then bagi tahu kalau ada problem, you want me to repeat ke, boleh. Or you can raise your hand dekat Google Meet ni pun boleh. Okay, saya akan continue. Alright. Like I mentioned earlier, what we are learning is basically under engineering mechanics. Okay, engineering mechanics ni is the study on how bodies ataupun rigid body react to the forces acting on them. Okay, sebelum ni you dah pernah ambil kursus statics. Okay, statics the study of bodies in equilibrium. Equilibrium maksudnya tak bergerak lah. Objek tu static sajalah. That's why it is called static. And then static menggunakan most of the principle dalam static menggunakan Newton first law of motion yang mengatakan kalau objek tu tidak bergerak, dia akan kekal tidak bergerak, ataupun kalau objek tu sedang bergerak, dia akan continue moving with the velocity, with the same velocity unless ada external force acting on it. So that is the Newton first law of motion yang mana di apply dalam subjek statics yang you dah belajar sebelum ni. In this course dynamics, it's now the study of motion because now the body is no longer in equilibrium. Dia bukan lagi static. Dia sekarang ni telah bergerak, mengalami pergerakan. So seperti yang saya inform sebelum ini, dalam dynamics we have two main topics that we are going to learn. The first one is kinematic, which is the geometric aspect of the motion, ataupun tadi saya sebut sebagai character of the motion, characteristic of the motion. So you have a few parameters ataupun variable yang you perlu tahu. S ni represent the displacement, berapa banyak dia telah bergerak dalam sesuatu masa. So S is the displacement. Boleh juga kita bagi tahu sebagai position tadi. So kalau ada perubahan position, kita tahulah berapa displacement dia. Kalau pada masa T sama dengan satu saat, objek tersebut berada pada kedudukan A, T equals to 3 seconds, dia telah move ke kedudukan B. So we will know what is the displacement of the object. So ini kita gunakan simbol S sebagai variable. V represent the velocity. Okay, macam biasa, velocity ialah speed of the object. Unit yang kita gunakan ialah meter per second. And then if the speed is changing over time, then you will have the acceleration A. And lastly, you have the time lah, T. So ini 4 important variable ataupun parameters yang kita akan calculate atau consider dalam chapter kinematics. So this will be the first chapter for dynamics lah. Okay, and then we will go into the second main topic, which is kinetics. And then this is how forces causing the motion. Macam saya explain tadi, setiap objek yang bergerak mesti ada force luaran, external force yang bertindak ke atas dia, which makes the object to move lah. Okay, objek tu move mesti ada force yang bertindak pada dia. So in dynamics, basically we are going to use the second Newton's law of motion. Kalau dalam static tadi kita gunakan Newton first law of motion, dalam dynamics kita menggunakan Newton's second law of motion, iaitu F equals to ma. Okay, force is equivalent to mass multiply with the acceleration. Okay, any question? Kalau ada question boleh raise your hand and ask, ataupun kalau malu nak cakap, you boleh tulis di chat box, saya akan bacakan dan saya akan cuba jawab lah. Okay, kalau tak ada soalan saya teruskan.
Okay, saya teruskan.
Okay, so next we will look into the cost structure. Okay, seperti saya maklumkan tadi, di dalam dynamics ni kita boleh pecahkan kepada dua bahagian. Satu is the particle dynamics. Ini yang kita akan belajar dalam kursus inilah untuk diploma level. Particle ni kita assume semua objek tu seperti satu titik particle. Contoh kita nak calculate berapa velocity kereta moving from point A ke point B. So kita consider kereta yang besar tu sebagai satu particle, satu titik sahaja. So kita akan kira dia based on dia punya center of gravity lah. Kita ambil titik center of gravity tu, kita kira moving kereta tu daripada A ke B. So this is what we are going to cover in diploma. For degree level, we will learn about rigid body dynamics. So ini a little bit more complicated than particle, because kalau kereta tadi kita consider sebagai satu titik untuk particle, untuk rigid body kita akan consider dia sebagai satu body lah, satu badan yang besar. So dia akan ada banyak-banyak titik dalam tu. So dia punya calculation dan pergerakan dia akan jadi lain. Tapi I don't want to explain more on rigid body dynamics, because this is not part of what we are going to learn dalam dynamics DMM 2523 ni lah. So DMM 2523 will only focus on particle dynamics on the left hand side. Okay, so as I have mentioned, dalam course outcomes tadi kita hanya ada 4 chapter yang kita akan cover dalam dynamics ini, iaitu the first one is particle kinematics chapter 1. And then we go into particle kinetics, di mana dipecahkan kepada tiga subtopik. So this, I will consider this as chapter 2, kinetics, force acceleration, chapter 3, work and energy, and chapter 4, impulse and momentum. So these are all the things yang kita akan belajar dalam kursus ini, dynamics. Okay. Next, this is also important. How are you going to be assessed dalam kursus ini? Macam mana saya akan menilai you untuk kursus dynamics ini? So these are all the assessment yang you akan hadapi dalam kursus dynamics ini. So there will be 5 quizzes, akan ada 5 quiz, akan ada 2 test, test 1 and test 2, and finally there will be a final examination. Okay? So setiap quiz ni akan membawa 6%. So very important lah for you to score in the quiz, because 6% is very big. Okay, kalau you score perfect mark dalam all the quizzes, you will already have 30 marks. Okay, 30 markah dah ada dalam tangan if you score very good in quiz. Okay, so quiz ada 5, setiap satunya 6%. So quiz 1 dan quiz 2 akan datang dari chapter 1. Okay, you will refer to CO ni, course outcome. CO1 means chapter 1 lah. So quiz 1 and quiz 2 comes from chapter 1. quiz 3 will come from chapter number 2. And then akan ada masa pertengahan semester before the semester break. My plan is before or maybe after the mid semester break, we will have test 1. So test 1 ni akan cover chapter 1 and chapter 2. Yes, Aidil. Ada soalan?
Kita buat secara online ataupun buat face to face?
Okay, nanti saya beritahu. Saya habiskan dulu ni. Saya dah beritahu sampai test 1. Test 1 tadi pada pertengahan semester kita akan buat test 1 iaitu yang akan cover chapter 1 dan chapter 2. And then we will go into chapter number 3 and then you will have quiz 4 yang akan cover chapter 3. And then we will go into the last chapter, chapter 4. And then you will have quiz 5 for chapter 4. And then at the end of the semester, minggu ke-14, minggu terakhir, you will have test 2 yang akan cover chapter 3 and also chapter 4. So chapter 3, chapter 4 will be covered in test 2. And finally, during the final exam week, you will have final exam. Dia akan contribute 40%. The question will come from chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. So setiap chapter ni bagi 10% lah kepada final exam. Okay, so adakah quiz dan test ni online ataupun face to face? Okay, that's why I did the survey just now to see whether all of you are coming back to the campus ataupun ada certain of you yang akan stay dekat rumah. So according to the survey ni, 47 orang yang dah respond to the survey, semua akan pulang ke kampus. Okay, semua dah lengkap 2 dos vaksin, semua akan pulang ke kampus. So my target is to do ada daripada Sabah Sarawak tak? Any of you here from Borneo?
Yes, me sir.
Yes sir.
Ada
sir.
Okay. So kalau ada, the Semenanjung student will come back this weekend kalau tak silap saya. Sabah Sarawak will come back during in week 3. So kita akan mula face to face starting week number 4 lah. So saya maybe quiz 1 and quiz 2 we will do it online. Starting quiz 3 we will do it face to face lah. So quiz 3, test 1 and so on ni akan jadi face to face. Once all of the students are in the campus, we can have face-to-face class. Okay. But kita punya class is 2 times a week. Okay, kita ada kelas hari Isnin dan kita ada kelas hari Rabu. I already have the videos of all lecture. So maybe, I'm not sure yet, maybe we will only see each other sekali sahaja seminggu for the tutorial session. The class on Monday, I will provide you with the video on the theory, which I explain about the theory and everything. And there is also example calculation in the video. So you will watch the video first. On Monday on your own in the hostel or whatever, and on Wednesday you will come to the class with me face to face, and then we will do tutorial. I will give you questions and we will answer together lah. So it's lebih kurang macam latih tubi macam tu. Do you agree with that method or you want to have face to face class 2 times a week? Macam mana? Oh, tapi because there are about 50 students in this class and we still need to practice physical distancing, I'm afraid that I have to divide you into 2 groups lah. So in that case, mungkin grup pertama akan datang ke kelas pada hari Isnin Because we need to have apa ni 1 meter distance penjarakan dalam kelas. So group pertama maybe around 25 students akan datang pada hari Senin untuk have face to face class with me. We have we will do tutorial and so on. The second group will come on Wednesday. So before before the apa ni during maybe on Friday macam tu, I will provide the video for you to watch first, so you can watch during weekend or whenever you are free, you have free time. And then Monday I will do tutorial with group 1, Wednesday I will do tutorial with group 2, the same tutorial. Is that okay with you?
Okay sir.
Okay yes, sir. Okay, so okay, basically setiap orang akan jumpa saya sekali sahajalah seminggu. If you have question berkenaan apa teori yang saya explain dalam video tu, you boleh tanya pada masa you jumpa saya lah. So saya akan ada kelas 2 kali seminggu, tapi you akan jumpa saya sekali sahaja seminggu, because you will be divided into 2 groups. Boleh faham eh?
Boleh sir, boleh sir.
Alright. Okay, so let's continue. Okay, this is how I plan the class lah. Okay, these are all the topics that we will cover in throughout the semester. Ini cuma saya punya perancangan. Kadang-kadang mungkin kita ada cuti lah dan sebagainya, so we have to adjust a bit. Tapi basically, this is how we are going to run the class lah. So today is week number one, class number one, introduction and rectilinear kinematics. Okay, so I will go a little bit into this after this, and then we will continue rectilinear kinematics in the second class on Wednesday. Next week we will go into erratic motion, lepas tu we'll go into curvilinear motion, and then week 3 projectile motion, week 3 class number 2 curvilinear motion, normal and tangential component. And then week 4 curvilinear motion, cylindrical component. Week 4 class number 2 absolute dependent motion, analysis of 2 particles. And week 5 class number 1 relative motion, analysis of 2 particles using translating axis. So yang warna yellow ni, yellowish brown ni ialah chapter 1. So kita akan habis chapter 1 ini pada minggu kelima. Okay, so 5 minggu yang pertama dalam semester ni kita akan belajar chapter 1. Chapter 1 ni basically chapter yang paling besar dalam dalam dynamics. Okay, and then week 5 class number 2 we will go into chapter 2, Newton's second law of motion. Saya akan explain sikit apa Newton's second law of motion, how we are going to use F equals to ma to calculate the other things lah, to calculate the acceleration and so on. And then week 6 we go into equation of motion. Equation of motion ni nama lain kepada F equals to ma tadi lah. So kalau people ask you about what is equation of motion, so you should know equation of motion is F equals to ma. It's basically the Newton's second law of motion. Okay, so we learn about equation of motion rectangular coordinate in week 6. Okay, apa rectangular coordinate ni nanti kita akan belajar. Rectangular coordinates, kalau dalam chapter 1 tadi ada rectangular component, dia benda yang sama. Coordinate dengan component ni samalah. Kadang-kadang jangan confuse lah, kadang-kadang saya guna rectangular component, kadang-kadang kita guna rectangular coordinate. So please do not get confused. And week 7 we will have apa ni, equation of motion, normal and tangential coordinates. So yang ni kita akan mula belajar tentang curvilinear motion. And finally equation of motion, cylindrical coordinate, also curvilinear motion. And then you will have mid-sem break. Sorry ya, tarikh ni salah. This was from last semester. Mid-sem break, sekejap eh, saya tengok balik mid-sem break bila. Mid-sem break is wait, mid-semester break is 27 November until 5 December. Okay, 27 November sehingga 5 December 2021 is mid-semester break. So you will have mid-semester break during that time. And then when you come back from the break, kita akan ada test one. Okay, so based on this current planning, test one will be pada minggu ke-8, week number 8, kelas yang pertama. Saya akan buat test during class time according to current planning lah. Maybe benda ni akan berubah, depends on situation nanti. So current planning is to do mid-sem break during class time lah, test one. To do the test one during class. And then we will go into the third chapter. After test one, we'll go into the third chapter, work and energy. Okay, so the work of a force kita akan belajar. We'll go into the principle of work and energy for a particle. And then we'll go into principle of work and energy for a system of particle. Ada banyak sikit particle. And then we'll learn about power and efficiency. Okay, ini pun my mistake. This was from last semester juga. Hari Raya Aidilfitri ni bukan lagi pada week ke-8 lah, dah tak ada hari raya dah tahun ni, tahun depan pula. So maybe we can bring the other chapter ke atas lah. Conservative forces and potential energy ni we can bring to week 10. And then week 11 kita akan habis dengan chapter 3, conservation of energy. That will be the last subtopic untuk chapter 3. And then we'll go into the last chapter, okay, maybe starting week 12 mungkin, principle of linear impulse and momentum. Okay, last chapter is on impulse and momentum. Ini pun kesilapan ni, saya akan update the slides later. Conservation of momentum, impact and coefficient of restitution, and finally principle of angular impulse and momentum. So ini akan habis pada week 14, kelas yang pertama. So the plan was to do test 2 in week 14, kelas yang kedua. Okay, itu kita punya initial planning lah. So ini mungkin akan ada perubahan lah, bergantung kepada cuti, bergantung kepada kalau ada cuti umum, kalau ada kalau in case saya ada ada hal yang saya terpaksa tangguh kelas dan sebagainya. So I will inform you from time to time lah. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan tentang class planning first half and second half of the semester and also the assignment? Kalau ada soalan, tak ada soalan eh?
Final exam semua topik kan?
Final exam semua topik, betul. So final exam tu akan cover keempat-empat chapter lah. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. Akan ada empat soalan lah dalam final exam. There will be four question. Soalan 1 daripada chapter 1, soalan 2 dari chapter 2, soalan 3 chapter 3, soalan 4 chapter 4. Kesemua ni membawa 25 markah dalam final exam. So total dia akan jadi 100% untuk final. Tapi untuk kursus dia akan bawa 40% saja. So basically daripada 25 markah tadi dia akan convert kepada 10% lah untuk final exam punya markah.
Okay. Kira-kira kita tiada assignment lah.
Assignment tak ada. So, saya akan ajar and then kita akan buat quiz. And then bila dah habis dua chapter, kita akan buat test one. Lepas tu saya masuk chapter 3, chapter 4 akan ada quiz untuk setiap chapter. And then habis dua chapter, kita buat test 2. And then pada minggu final exam akan ada final exam. Macam tu saja kita punya assessment. Okay, ada lagi soalan?
Ada lagi.
Okay, what is the reference book? This will be the main reference book yang saya akan guna. Basically, we will follow this chapter from this book lah. So ada empat chapter, chapter 12, 13, 14, 15. So this corresponds to the chapter yang saya mention tadi. So chapter 12 ni ialah particle kinematics. So dia merangkap chapter 1 yang kita cover dalam kursus dynamic ni. Chapter 13 dalam buku ni will be chapter 2 in our class. Chapter 14 ialah work and energy. So dia akan jadi chapter 3. And 15 will be chapter 4. Okay. Cuma dalam buku ni, dia maybe I can show you the book je. Eh. Saya cuba cari. Do not get confused with the rigid body punya dynamic. Sebab tadi saya mention rigid body you will learn in degree, at degree level. So, sekejap, eh. Look at the chapter. Okay. Okay, sekejap saya share the book. Okay, can you see the book now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the content dalam buku yang saya tunjuk tadi, Hibbler. Let's look at the book. Okay, ini RC Hibbler, Engineering Mechanics Dynamic 14th Edition, edisi ke-14. Okay, so kalau you tengok content, Chapter 12, Kinematics of Particle. So this will be our Chapter 1, right? Chapter 13, Kinetics of Particle, Force Acceleration. This will be our chapter 2. Okay, 14, Kinetics of Particle, Work Energy. This will be our chapter 3. And Kinetics of Particle, Impulse and Momentum. This will be chapter 4, chapter last. Jangan confuse dengan chapter 16. Kat sini you nampak kinematics juga. Tapi dia tulis Kinematics of Rigid Body. Ini untuk degree. Kita tak cover dalam diploma. Okay, dia sama saja. 16 kinematics tapi rigid body. Yang tadi kita punya kinematics particle. Okay, that is the difference. Yang 13 kita kinetic force acceleration. Chapter 17 pun sama. Kinetic force and acceleration but it is for rigid body. Okay, so do not get confused. Saya tak, ada certain student yang sebelum ni dia salah refer. Dia bila dia nak buat latihan ke apa, dia pergi buat latihan pada chapter yang lain, yang depan punya. So this is not covered in our course. Okay, yang ni untuk degree. So 16, 17, 18, 19 is for degree punya. Kita tak cover. Kalau you tengok rigid body ni, this is not part of this dynamics course. You punya ialah only 12, 13, 14 dan 15 sahaja. Okay, I hope that's clear lah. Yes, Aidil.
Sir, PDF tu boleh dapatkan kat mana?
PDF ni saya boleh share nanti tapi sebenarnya illegal lah untuk saya share pada you. Sekejap I will think about it. Macam mana saya nak share. Takpelah, I will share but you jangan share kepada orang lain lah, you faham tak? Sebab nanti kalau apa-apa dia macam the person responsible sharing the ni ialah saya lah. Or you can try to Google, boleh juga jumpa. Okay. Alright, so that will be my first presentation. Okay, sekarang saya nak tunjukkan tentang kalam. Semua dah pernah guna kalam kan?
Pernah, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So for this class, I will use kalam as the platform untuk saya letakkan kita punya materials, videos dan sebagainya lah. Okay, so if you log in into your kalam, this is my kalam lah. Ini macam mana yang saya nampak. Saya pun tak sure macam mana you nampak as a student. It should be the same lah lebih kurang. So if you go into DMM 2523 Dynamics, you akan nampak ni lah saya dah masukkan sedikit material. Saya dah letakkan course synopsis. Ini sama saja dalam slide yang saya tunjukkan tadi. And then you have the course outcomes. Basically ini the four course outcomes is showing you the chapter yang kita akan belajar dalam Dynamics ni. So basically there will be four chapters. Okay, or also known as course outcomes. And then saya letakkan juga tentang engineering mechanics ni, okay, ada statics dan dynamics, sedikit explanation for your reference. And then the structure of the course, saya nak emphasize sekali lagi that rigid body is not part of this course. Okay, we only cover particle dynamics on the left hand side. And then saya letakkan gambar untuk assessment, okay, for your reference, how the assessment, the percentage is distributed, okay, quiz 1, quiz 2 dan sebagainya ni, berapa persen ni for your reference, and dia datang dari chapter mana. So this is important also, bila datangnya quiz, bila datang test tu, you tahu nak study chapter mana. And then I put this reference book, okay. And then you will see week 1. Okay, saya dekat tepi sebelah kiri ni pun ada week 1. So if you click week 1, dia akan keluar materials yang saya upload for you to watch, and also you can download the lecture notes untuk week 1. So I will update this every week lah. So ni week 1, week lain belum keluar. So before week 2, maybe during the weekend, I will upload week 2 punya material. Okay, so dekat sini you will see lecture videos. This is lecture videos from last semester punya class. But basically it is the same lah. So you can watch here the video. Click kat sini boleh. Dia akan just playback terus my video. And then this is for the second video, constant acceleration. So throughout this week, I want you to watch these two videos lah and try to understand. And in the next class, kalau you ada soalan, kita akan you boleh tanya, saya akan jawab. And then we will do more tutorials in the class. So I think this will help you a lot in answering the question later dalam quiz, dalam test dan juga final exam. I will not explain much on the theoretical part dalam class. The theoretical part tu has already been explained in the videos. Okay, kalau you nak tengok ni tentang constant acceleration, you will click here. I explain everything about the constant acceleration dalam video ni. So you can watch the video and then we will do the tutorial sama-sama later lah. Dekat sini pun ada lecture notes which you can click to download lah. You click here, the PDF will appear. Basically this is the slide lah yang saya tunjukkan tadi. Okay, alright. So column is where you will find all the materials. Any question? For now, do you have any question?
So far no.
More clear? Okay. So how many we have here? 47, including me. So only 46. So sepatutnya ada 3 orang lagi lah yang should join this class. Tapi tak apa. Okay, actually I'm not planning to do kelas yang panjang for today. This is just introduction punya kelas. So what I want you to do is to watch these videos lah. You watch these two videos before the class on Wednesday. Wednesday, I'm not sure yet if I can do the class or not because I have something to do. I will update later, tapi I'm not sure. Maybe we will have class online macam ni, Google Meet, atau if I have to postpone the class, I will inform in the WhatsApp group lah. But as for now, I want you to watch these two videos and try to understand what I explain in the video. And if we will have class on Wednesday, I will explain what I explain in the video. I will if you have question, I will explain again on Wednesday, and I will prepare some tutorial question so that we will answer the question together in the class. Kalau you tak tahu nak jawab macam mana, I can help you to do the tutorial. Okay, is that clear?
Yes. Yeah. So nak tanya.
Yes.
Untuk quiz, how many attempt kita boleh buat?
How many attempt? Sekali je lah attempt. Sekali attempt, tapi quiz tu will be not as strict as test and final exam lah. You faham tak? Kalau test tu macam kita akan buat dalam dewan peperiksaan yang ada major seorang-seorang dan sebagainya. But the quiz, if we do the quiz face to face, kita akan buat dalam kelas macam biasalah. So itu jelah beza dia, and then the difficulty level pun definitely akan less difficult lah, more basic question untuk quiz compared to test dan juga final exam. Tapi kalau you tanya berapa attempt, setakat yang saya practice sampai semester yang lepas, sekali je lah. But depends on the performance. Kalau tiba-tiba kita tengok quiz 1 tu contohnya daripada 49, 50 orang student, 40 dapat markah yang sangat teruk, so maybe I will repeat the quiz lah. Tapi I hope that will not happen. Okay. Any other question?
So quiz tu akan dalam bentuk kertas je lah nanti. Tak secara okay. Online lah.
Seperti yang saya bagi tahu tadi, quiz 1 dengan quiz 2 maybe kita akan buat online. So saya akan gunakan Google Form lah. So basically saya akan bagi you link Google Form, you buka Google Form tu, you isi nama dan student ID, and then akan ada soalan akan appear dekat situ. You calculate on paper, tulis jawapan you on paper, and then you ambil gambar, upload in the Google Form tu balik. So that is how I practice my online punya assessment lah setakat ni. Itu untuk quiz 1, quiz 2 macam tu lah. When all of you are here in the campus, kita akan buat quiz dan juga test tu secara face to face lah. Okay. Ada lagi soalan lain?
No, sir.
Okay. No more question?
No more.
Alright. Okay. So, my plan is to end the class now because I have the videos ready for you to watch. Ataupun you want me to continue with the first chapter. It's basically the same as what I have in the video lah. So do you prefer me to explain now live to you, or you want to watch the video? Any feedback?
Sir.
Yeah.
Tengok video dulu, lepas tu saya explain.
Tengok video dulu, okay. In that case, you will watch the video first, and then we will see each other on Wednesday. Kalau saya boleh buat kelas, kalau tak kita jumpa next week. And then if you have a question regarding the video, you boleh tanya pada hari itulah. Okay, eh? Oh, jap. Cuma saya nak tunjuk lagi satu benda about the video, eh. Jap, eh. Let me, okay, saya dah kat sini. How do I go to? Okay. Bila you click playback di kalam ni, saya tak sure kalau you guna phone dia nampak macam mana, tapi ini saya guna laptop. You boleh click dekat YouTube simbol dekat bawah ni, dia akan pergi ke page YouTube. Okay. Apa bezanya, kalau you tengok dekat sini, you have to watch the video daripada awal sampai habis lah. Video ni panjang. Because it was recorded during class in the last semester. Cuma kalau you pergi ke YouTube ni, saya ada buatkan bawah ni dia panggil chapter. Kalau you klik bawah ni, you boleh tengok view chapter. So bila you klik view chapter ni, saya dah letakkan, saya dah pecah-pecahkan video tu ikut chapter. So you can look, awal-awal ni saya explain sampai reference book. Kalau you tak nak tengok yang ni, you tak payah tengok, you boleh terus pergi ke, let's say you want to watch Introduction to Dynamics. So you click Introduction to Dynamics, dia akan terus skip the video tu pergi kepada chapter yang saya dah buat tadi lah. Jap, kenapa dia tak playback? Oh, dia loading sikit sekejap, eh. Okay,
can
so
you see the slides?
Dia terus pergi ke Introduction to Dynamics, and then okay, let's say kalau dekat sini, so, let me pause it first. Okay, let's say you dah watch Introduction to Dynamics, you dah tengok semua video, and then you macam tak faham tentang velocity contohnya, so you want to repeat velocity, You can use this chapter also. You click on velocity, dia akan terus pergi ke pergi ke section di mana saya explain tentang velocity. Okay, so it is better for you to watch in YouTube punya page lah rather than you watch in Kalam. Tapi I will put the video in Kalam, but you open it in YouTube punya page so that you can use this chapter punya features. You faham tak apa yang saya cerita ni?
Faham, sir.
Cuma I'm not sure kalau you watch this in phone, YouTube dalam phone saya tak pasti you boleh view the chapters or not. Tapi kalau dalam phone you kena skip lah. You kena apa gunakan dia punya ni bar dekat bawah ni to skip the content lah. Tapi kalau you buka dekat laptop, dekat computer, you boleh pergi ke certain chapter. And then kalau let's say you nak terus jump to the tutorial pun, macam dalam video ni I have shown two tutorials. Okay, you boleh terus klik pada tutorial. So you can look at my explanation on how to solve the problem for the first tutorial lah. Okay, so ini the first tutorial. You playback, saya akan tunjukkan macam mana dia punya guna calculation, step by step calculation lah. Okay, so I think it's better. It will save a lot of time if you watch the video first, and then kalau you ada question, you boleh tanya dalam the next class, and during class time kita focus on doing tutorial, because if I repeat this the same thing again, it's gonna be the same lah, because I have recorded all the lecture from last semester. So I think it's better for you to watch the lecture video first, and then dalam class kita buat tutorial saja. Okay, I think that will improve your performance in this course, because kita akan buat lebih banyak soalan lah, kita akan jawab lebih banyak soalan, and when you are facing the same problem in the test, in the final exam, you will know how to solve the problem. Okay, I hope that's clear, and I hope you agree with the method that I plan to use for this class lah. Boleh?
Boleh, sir.
Boleh, sir.
Okay. Any more question? Attendance. Okay, that's a good one. Saya pun lupa pasal attendance. Okay, jap eh. Attendance, saya akan, how do I do this? Let me create a Google form lah for you to isi attendance. Oh, wait, let me stop sharing first. Saya try to view all the participants. Let's see. Boleh nampak tak semua orang? Okay. I will do the Google form lah sekejap eh. Let me prepare Google form sekejap for you to fill in the attendance. Okay, jap. Almost done. Okay. Attendance. Copy. Okay, I will put in the chat box. Okay, this will be the link for attendance. You just sign in to your Google account. Lepas tu isi ID saja. Okay. So if you can do that now. So I think that's all for today. Today I plan to just do the introduction of the class. How am I going to go about doing the class, how macam mana perjalanan kelas. So I have explained that. And then I have explained about the reference book about Kalam, where I will put all the materials there. And I have also explained about the lecture videos. Okay, so I want you to watch the videos first, and then in the next class, we will discuss about the lesson that you watch in the video. If you have question, kita akan discuss. I will explain again, and then we will do a lot of tutorials during the class lah, rather than doing the theory. The theory part you watch in the video, and we do a lot of tutorials, calculation in the class. I think that will be much more beneficial for you lah. Okay, so if there is no more question, ada lagi soalan? If there's no more question, I think I would like to end the class now. Kalau tak ada apa-apa lagi soalan, ada lagi soalan? Any more question?
No, sir.
Okay, so kalau tak ada soalan, thank you for joining the class today. I hope all of you are safe from the COVID-19 virus. Okay, and I will see you again probably on Wednesday, tapi I will inform in the WhatsApp group. As for now, class on Wednesday is as usual. Kalau if I cannot do the class on Wednesday, I will inform in the WhatsApp group. Okay. So I will see you again on Wednesday using the same link as today. Dia punya Google Meet link is the same, and we will discuss about the tutorial punya ni lah on what you have watched, the two videos that I provided in the in Kalam. Okay, so please go to Kalam, watch the two videos. You can use the chapter function to skip if you want, and then we will discuss more about that on Wednesday. Okay, please remember to fill in the attendance, and I will see you again on Wednesday. Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum and very good morning.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.